Hello and welcome to the Times of India. I am Sanjeev Singh. The results of 2017 assembly elections are out and BJP has done really well in the state of Uttar Pradesh, and as far as the trends go right now, they are almost touching 300 of out of the 403 seats on their own. If we add their allies, the number goes well beyond 300. Now the next question that everyone will be asking is, who is going to be the next chief minister of Uttar Pradesh, the most populous state in India? To discuss more about this, I have with me Times of India's Sanjeev Shankaran. Sanjeev, there are a lot of names, of course, with senior leaders. They have 71 MPs from Uttar Pradesh, but who are the likely contenders and why do you think they're in the contention?
The most likely contender right now seems to be Keshav Prasad Maurya. He has been closely associated with this campaign right from the beginning. And when we discussed BJP's strategy ahead of the polling, all of us talked, and you visited UP quite a few times in the run-up to the election. And you did talk a few times about BJP trying to consolidate the non-Yadav OBC vote.
Yes.
So if that were the case, wouldn't Keshav Prasad Maurya fit the bill? I mean, he's got... If there's a checklist, he ticks most of them.
Yeah, in fact, talking about Keshav Prasad Maurya, one of the pros that goes in his favor is the fact that he's relatively younger than most of the other people in the fray, and also the fact that he's been associated with the RSS ever since his early youth. So that's a big plus for him.
Wasn't he also part of the Ram Janmabhoomi movement?
Yes. So, you know, he has all the right credentials as far as the BJP is concerned. And also the fact that that you said that, you know, BJP has been focusing a lot on the non-Yadav OBC vote. So, that is something where Keshav Prasad Maurya fits in. But then what are the cons, do you think, that could go against him?
See, Keshav Prasad Maurya, compared to a couple of other people we'll be talking about a little later, in terms of administration and so on, he's relatively inexperienced. Uttar Pradesh is by far the most complicated state to administer in India. It's the size of many a country. And
it's bigger than Brazil.
Absolutely. And in terms of population, it's bigger than any average West European country, European country, for example. Now, we have a situation where if you were to keep Narendra Modi aside, if you were to look at a face that BJP did try and project in some certain way, it was Keshav Prasad Maurya. But he's also a man with very, very little experience.
Sanjay, hold that thought. We're getting in some comments. Umesh says that Yogi Adityanath should be the next CM of BJP in Uttar Pradesh, whereas Ajit says that it should be Rajnath Singh. So, we'll come to the other slides first, but let's talk about Keshav Prasad Maurya. The fact that when his name was announced sometime last year,
right. There
was a lot of, it was seen as a surprise move because they were expecting some heavyweight to actually take charge. But Amit Shah and Modi actually had faith in him, and I think they had a plan well in advance that this is how they're going to go about the UP election, which is where Keshav Prasad Maurya he fit the bill for them as far as that was concerned.
And for many of our viewers, it might also be of interest to notice that that Keshav Prasad Maurya also sold tea in his early... I mean, he comes from a modest background financially, and he was a tea seller for a while, and he also sold newspapers. So,
and I can also see him wearing... the Neelam, the ring, that is a ring that not everyone can wear. It either take you to the top or can take you to the bottom. But in this case, since he's already first on our list, perhaps he will be one of the strong contenders.
Okay, let's take a look at now. Manoj Sinha, far more experienced than Keshav Prasad Maurya, older too. He's about 55 years old, if I'm not mistaken. He's an engineer by training, and he holds two very important portfolios in the Narendra Modi central government.
Yeah.
He is a minister of state with independent charge of telecommunications, so he handles the telecom bit. He also concurrently holds the railway portfolio as a junior minister.
Sanjeev, just some more comments coming in. We've got Saurabh saying it should be Minister Sinha. Yes, we're going to come to more details for that. Chirag Patel, for some reason, thinks that Piyush Goyal could be the best face for Uttar Pradesh CM. Hardik says either Dinesh Sharma, Manoj Sinha or Keshav Prasad Maurya. Mohit Pandey says Yogi Adityanath, Arjun Mishra, Adityanath, Ram Mohan Singh, Adityanath, Prakhar Jain, Adityanath, Ghanshyam Mohanty, Yogi Ji. Pranav Kumar, Yogi Ji.
He's a popular by...
We also have Yash saying that I think Smriti Irani should be the next CM of UP. So, a lot of, these coming in, comments coming in. And please send us more of your comments so that we also get a sense of what you exactly feel about who could be the next CM of UP. So, talking about...
Sanjeev, you've interacted with Mr. Sinha quite often, haven't you? I mean, how do you rate his chances?
See, the first point actually says a lot about Manoj Sinha, non-controversial.
Yeah.
So, he's the sort of people, in that sense, he's like a Rajnath Singh who'd like to carry everyone together. And if you see, he's actually been promoted in the past 2 years in the Narendra Modi government. He was earlier just a minister of state.
Right.
He held the railways portfolio at that time. And then he actually got an upgrade to...
About telecommunications.
Yeah, so that says a lot. Plus, he hails from Eastern UP and
right. He
has been one of the ministers responsible for ensuring that the eastern portion, which includes Prime Minister's constituency of Varanasi,
right. Gets
all the development work going.
Yes.
So that has been one major plus point. So there is a lot of faith that the Narendra Modi government has in his abilities, which is why we think that he could also be a probable contender.
But you feel that his appeal probably is not pan-UP, in the sense he's largely seen as an Eastern UP leader, is it?
Yeah, because, as far as Manoj Sinha is concerned, this is the first time that he's actually gone out of his base of Eastern UP as a
right. As
a central minister. So, given the sort of responsibility he had so far,
right. He's
very happy to play the role of a, limited player, very content with what he has. And perhaps that is one of the reasons why he's been a non-controversial leader. Even though he's been in politics for such a long time, over 2 decades.
Right.
But you never see his name figuring in any sort of controversy.
Yeah, I think it's over 20 years ago when he first got elected, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. Again, we've got some more comments coming in. Pranav says, to fix law and order, we need Yogi Ji. Akshay says, Manoj Sinha or Rajnath Singh. Abbas Loharwala says, Manoj Sinha. Himanshu Tiwari says Amit Shah.
Well, I don't think that's going to happen. Amit Shah will continue to be the chief campaign strategist for BJP.
There's also Naimuddin who says it could be Uma Bharti. And Ram Mohan Singh says that UP needs a determined CM and should not lack luster. So, determined, yes, but going by the pattern that, the Amit Shah, Narendra Modi combination has of appointing chief ministers,
yes.
Be it Raghuvar Das in Jharkhand or Khattar in Haryana. What do you think are Manoj Sinha's chances?
He probably is not the favorite, is my assessment at this moment, because, given the social composition of UP and the kind of support that BJP has, I would probably assume that Manoj Sinha might not make the grade on a couple of those important aspects. But he also happens to be a trusted minister for Narendra Modi in the center. He's been given two important infrastructure segments, railways and telecommunications.
So more comments coming in. Ayush Saxena says Manoj Sinha. Harshvardhan says Mr. Sinha. Dhananjay Verma says Amit Shah. Shweta Gupta says Yogi Adityanath. Babu Biswas, Smriti Irani, Sunil Tripathi, Yogi Adityanath, Tahmina Azad says Amit Shah. We've got a new candidate. Abhishek Shah says that Shri Murli Manohar Joshi should be the candidate. From Mark Darshak Mandal to... Yeah.
The impression we've got about Mark Darshak Mandal is the place you... put people when you want to give them a decent retirement package before they completely retire.
What?
So it's a bit unlikely he'll come back into active.
One more comment. Saurabh Singh says, Manoj Sinha is like Devendra Fadnavis. Non-controversial and will toe party line. May become a star like Shivraj Chauhan.
That's an interesting comparison he's made. Because Shivraj Chauhan was also, he had some of these attributes when we first started talking about him. he was also non-controversial, and at that point in time, after Uma Bharati, everybody felt that he didn't have the same kind of appeal in Madhya Pradesh, and he's turned out to be a very, very successful chief minister for BJP.
Nishant Singh, more comments. Nishant Singh says, Manoj Sinha, Prashant Gupta, Smriti Irani, Shraddha Gupta, Rajnath Singh, Manish Anand, Manoj Sinha has a clear image, clean image, he should be CM. So, Gaurav says we need a chief minister like Narendra Modi.
Well, everybody can't be Narendra Modi.
Exactly, I was about to say the same thing. But one thing we can decipher from the comments that we're getting from you is the fact that Manoj Sinha is actually quite non-controversial. In COVID. Let's look at some other. Yeah.
You know, Mahesh Sharma happens to be an MP from an area adjoining Delhi. That is, he's in Noida, Gautam Buddha Nagar. Again, a lifelong RSS member. So he's very close to the Sangh, a Brahmin face, but I'm not sure if as a group they are really important in the electoral scheme of things. And he's attracted a fair share of controversy as a minister for culture.
He spoke about Sanskritic Pradushan and how the government should get rid of it. So perhaps earlier he was seen more like, you know, someone actually aggressively pushing the so-called RSS agenda. But otherwise, if you see that the sort of he also has, as the picture clearly says, he has that sort of trust with Narendra Modi and Amit Shah, and plus he's a Brahmin face, so maybe, you know, if you talk about caste factors, even though you may not agree with me that BJP is focusing on the OBC vote, but maybe it's because we are discussing only contenders,
right,
this also could be a factor if at all, you know, a decision like that is taken.
You know, another useful nugget of information about Mahesh Sharma, because of his statements, a lot of people overlook his background. He's actually a doctor by training, and he's also a healthcare entrepreneur, in the sense he runs a series of clinics.
Yeah, the famous Kailash Hospital. Sanjeev, more comments coming in from people. Ankit says Rajnath Singh. Vivek Bishnoi says anyone except Smriti Irani. Shrikant says Yogi Adityanath. Zameer Sayed.
I think at this point in time, maybe we should go to the slide.
We'll just go there. Zameer Sayed says Rajnath Singh. Prakash says Yogi Adityanath. Dhananjay says huge respect for Modi and BJP. Krishna Arjun Day is asking any chance of Siddharthnath Singh being there.
What do you think, Sanjeev? Siddharthnath Singh, does he have a chance?
Well, at this point of time, everyone has a chance, because as we discussed, the sort of chief ministers we've seen that Modi has actually appointed in the past, be it...
Manohar Lal Khattar was a complete surprise, wasn't it?
Yeah.
His selection was a surprise.
Considering the fact that, you know, a significant number of Jats had voted for BJP in Haryana, there was this feeling that maybe to consolidate the Jat vote, they would appoint a Jat CM, but that did not happen. We saw Manohar Lal Khattar, who had practically no experience in running the administration, appointed.
Yeah, he was an RSS Pracharak primarily.
Then in Jharkhand, Raghubar Das, it wasn't a tribal. Normally, tribals have been, the norm has been to appoint tribals.
Could we see something like that in UP, where somebody who is a dark horse completely, I mean...
That's where perhaps Siddharthnath Singh would fit the bill. Because he's fighting this election, and he was leading.
He must have come close to winning by now. He was leading considered by a comfortable margin.
Sitaram Dhaniwal says Dalit may be leader in UP. It is essential to consolidate votes of majority.
So who would that be? Who would be the most likely candidate in that case?
If we are discussing, it could be someone from either the Nishad community or from the Parsi community, but it's slightly unlikely right now, because perhaps, you know, the non-Yadav OBC has been the forefront of BJP's campaign, so one can expect something on those lines to take place in the immediate future, and maybe have more ministers representing the non-Jat of Dalits in the ministry of whoever takes power.
Right.
So let's go
to the slide of the person who's attracted most attention from our viewers today. Yogi Adityanath is actually a very young man. He's the fifth consecutive term as MP from Gorakhpur. He first became MP when he was 26 years old. He's now about 45 years old. he's a Mahant. Right? Yeah. He has a sort of religious appeal that now nobody else has. And would I be wrong in saying that he has a support base that is independent of BJP?
Well, you can say that to an extent, and especially before the Narendra Modi factor came into UP politics in 2014, there was a lot of clout that Yogi Adityanath had. He still enjoys that clout. In fact, there was a time when in the days of Atal Bihari Vajpayee and L.K. Advani that senior leaders would actually go and visit Gorakhpur at that time to meet Yogi Adityanath just to make sure that, you know, everything is well, because as this slide has, that he's had an uneasy relationship with BJP. So if there are certain issues or things that he feels that the BJP is not going strong on because of various political reasons, then he has that streak of being an independent person or a rebel.
Doesn't he have his own foot soldiers? He doesn't rely on the RSS for help, let's say, in his electoral campaign.
See, there is an outfit called the Hindu Yuva Vahini,
right,
which has basically been floated by some of his supporters, and that to a large extent is influential in a few districts around Gorakhpur. So there is an old saying ki agar Gorakhpur mein rehna hai to yogi yogi kehna hai, which basically sums up the sort of firebrand leader that Yogi Adityanath is. Let's take a few more comments. Divyansh says it should be about Brahmins and Dalits. The Brahmins and Dalits themselves have voted for development. We should have a progressive chief minister with the main agenda as development. Farhan Gaur says Syed Shahnawaz Hussain should have one chance, but
he's from Bihar
and going by the fact that the BJP did not give him a single ticket to Muslims looks highly unlikely. Kartik says why Dalit or Brahmin, someone who is impartial to all. Arpit says BJP will make CM on basis of secularism, caste will not be the influencing factor.
You know, as somebody who's covered UP elections many times, do you think UP election can ever be fought independent of caste?
Till now, it's almost impossible to do that. In 2014, perhaps, it was the first time that we saw that people wanted to vote for a particular person.
Right.
The persona that Narendra Modi had. And that had been the overriding factor.
And
in this assembly election, when we traveled and we spoke to a lot of other journalists who were traveling, there was no overarching theme in the sense that, you know, we want to vote for Narendra Modi or any particular issue that should have actually dominated headlines. But it seems that, you know, there was this silent voter which wanted change from the traditional Samajwadi Party and Bahujan Samaj Party, and give one chance to Narendra Modi and see whether development actually comes to you.
Sanjeev, Shivansh Khanna suggested Kalraj Mishra.
Huh.
Let's discuss Kalraj Mishra, Rajnath Singh separately after slide of a person whose name has not figured so far from a leader's response.
In fact, even Chetan Bhatia says, why not Pankaj Singh? He's new and no issues of the past.
Right.
Let's look at the next slide and see what we have.
Now, none of our viewers so far have suggested Varun Gandhi, but Sanjeev, you felt that a lot of BJP workers personally like him very much.
Yeah, in fact, you know, what is interesting is that during the election campaign, at various rallies of BJP, if you actually interacted with the young cadre of BJP, one felt that both Yogi Adityanath and Varun Gandhi, they enjoyed a lot of support amongst the youth, the youth cadre within the BJP.
Right.
But what we've seen that, you know, even in the elections, like when the first list of campaigners came out for BJP, Varun Gandhi's name was not there. Then he was subsequently included in the second list. So the fact that he commands that respect and he's popular amongst the BJP cadre, that is a fact that cannot be ignored. But what again goes totally against him is the fact that, you know, the BJP leadership may not have that sort of faith in him, which has been reflected in the fact that he was not given as much responsibility as one assumed he would have got.
Right. Now, Sanjeev, let's go to one name that has figured frequently, but we don't have a slide on him, Rajnath Singh. What do you think his chances are?
See, in all the interviews that have happened so far, Rajnath Singh has already said that he's not interested in going back to Lucknow. perhaps in a scenario where if BJP had got 180 seats, where they needed to add some more MLAs to form the government, there Rajnath Singh could have come in handy. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't seem to have happened. There's also talk of Vinay Kathiar and Smriti Irani, you know, but I think let's put a stop to it for the moment.
Kalraj Mishra, last one.
Kalraj Mishra, he's already a minister and plus he's already over 75 years of age. So I think the age factor will go against him in the long run. So on that note, thank you so much for watching, and we'll come back to you for more updates. Keep watching The Times of India.
Thank you.